Morning student, today we'll discuss our fifth unit, yoga. Yoga, the word yoga is derived from the Sanskrit word use. Use means to join. Patanjali is the founder of yoga. According to Patanjali, use means to stabilize the mind for union of Atma with Paramatma. So, yoga means union of Atma with Paramatma, that is union of soul with God. Okay, Atma means soul and Paramatma means God. So yoga means the union of Atma with Paramatma. According to Swami Digambar ji, yoga is union of Atma with Paramatma. According to Satyapal, yoga is derived from the Sanskrit word use. It is derived from the Sanskrit word use. Use means to join, to union. So yoga means the union of soul with God. Purpose. The purpose of yoga is to provide sound body with tension free, sound mind, etc. Okay, the purpose of yoga is to provide you sound body with ekdam full relaxed, tension free. And the aim of yoga is self-identification, self-perfection, which come through self-realizations and self-purification. Okay, the aim, yoga means the union of Atma and Paramatma, and the aim of yoga is self-identifications, self-perfection, which come through self-purification. We achieve our aim by purifying ourselves. When we purify ourselves, then we are able to achieve our aim of yoga, that is self-identification. Through self-purification and self-realization. For purification of body and mind, the purification of body and mind is possible through eight elements, eight states. After achieving the eight states, eight elements of yoga, then there is union of soul with the God. Okay. For self-purifications, self-perfections, there are eight elements of yoga. According to Ashtang Yoga, Patanjali has described many types of yoga, and we are discussing about Ashtang Yoga. According to Ashtang Yoga, yoga has eight elements, that is Yam, Niyam, Asan, Pranayam, Pratyahar, Dharna, Dhyan, Samadhi. These are the eight states, eight elements of yoga. After achieving this eight states, there will be the union of Atma with Paramatma. For union of Atma with Paramatma, we have to achieve this eight states. We have to achieve this eight states of eight states, eight elements. After completing this eight states, then we can achieve our aim. Okay, aim of yoga is self-identification, self-perfection. Importance of yoga. Yoga is science as well as art of living. Okay, we say yoga is science. Science, because in yoga we study about the effect of exercise on our body. If we do asan, pranayam, what will be its effect on our body? So yoga is a science, and it is art because in yoga we perform activity, exercise, therefore it is a art. So yoga is art as science as well as art of living. For healthy, happy and prosperous life, thus its effect are mostly internal. The effect of yoga is internal. The effect of yoga is achieved after a long period of time, and its effect is permanent. Regular practice of yoga develop and purify our body and mind to the optimum level, to the maximum level. If we continuously do yoga, if we practice yoga, asana, pranayama, then it's help to purify our body, mind, etc. And also helps to remove from health hazard disease, cure from many chronic disease, improve, helps in proper growth and development of our body, etc. Let's discuss some importance of yoga. First is improve cardiovascular endurance. If we do yoga, especially asana, pranayama, it improves the efficiency of the cardiovascular system. Our cardiovascular system will be improved. Therefore, our endurance will be improved. Away from cardiac problem, if we do yoga, it helps to prevent from various cardiac problem, that is heart attack, heart failures, etc. Because yoga give a gentle massage. Yoga and asanas give the gentle massage to our heart and abdominal. Therefore, it helps to keep away from cardiac problem. Proper functioning of digestive organs. If we perform yoga, that is asana, pranayama, and kriya, it's help in proper functioning of our digestive system. Our digestive system will function properly. Moreover, it's help to improve our immunity system. If our digestive organ function properly, it's improve our immunity system also. Control over sense organs. By performing yoga, we will be able to control our sense organs, like pranayama, meditations, concentrations. We are able to control our sense organs. So yoga helps in controlling our sense organ also. It relax the body from pain, stress, and help to stabilize the mind. Relax stress and tension. Yoga relax the body and mind. It give full relax after performing the yoga. It helps in removing the stress tension of our body. Thus, we feel the freshness of our mind and soul completely. We feel completely fresh after performing the yoga. Develop concentrations. Yoga helps to develop our concentration, like meditation technique, stabilize the deflected mind in a proper function, proper direction. Good posture. By performing asana, it's tone up the body and its muscle. It saves the body to look attractive. It reduce excessive fat. If we do asana, it helps to reduce the excessive fat from our body. Therefore, our body body weight is also controlled. Our body structure will also good. We will our exercise, our posture, body position will be also good. It prevent obesity and also helps to regulate proper diet according to individual needs. Remove from auto problem. Many types of chronic auto problem. Auto problems, that is arthritis, joint pain, spondylitis, backache, etc. This type of auto bones related problem, it can be cured through yoga. Cure disease. Yoga practice prevent and cure many डिजीज लाइक कोल्ड, कफ, अस्थमा, गैस्ट्रिक प्रॉब्लम, कॉन्स्टिपेशंस, हाई ब्लड प्रेशर एक्सेट्रा. इफ वी परफॉर्म योगा इट्स हेल्प्स टू क्योर फ्रॉम दिस टाइप ऑफ डिजीज. प्रिवेंट प्री मैच्योर एजिंग. योगा हेल्प्स टू प्रिवेंट फ्रॉम प्री मैच्योर एजिंग. आवर एजिंग, आवर ओल्डेस्ट फैक्टर्स कैन बी डीले एंड इट्स हेल्प इट्स एंड ऑप्टिमम हेल्दी लिविंग कैन बी अटेन. दैट इज आवर प्री मैच्योर द एजिंग एजिंग फैक्टर्स विल बी डीले. इम्प्रूव हेल्थ एंड हाइजीन. योगा प्रैक्टिस इम्प्रूव द हेल्थ एंड डेवलप हाइजीनिकल हैबिट हैबिट इन द इंडिविजुअल. योगा गिव यू अ हाइजीनिक इम्प्रूव डेवलप द हाइजीनिकल हैबिट एंड इट्स हेल्प्स टू लीव अ हेल्दी हैप्पी पीसफुल एंड प्रॉस्परस लाइफ अहेड. दिस आर द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ योगा. First thing, what is yoga? Yoga is derived from the Sanskrit word use. Use means to join. So yoga means to join Atma with Paramatma, that is union of Atma with Paramatma. Aim of yoga is self-identification, self-identification, self-perfection, which we get from self-purification of body and mind. And for purification of body and mind is possible through eight elements of yoga. If we pass out these eight states, then there will be the purification of our body and mind. If there is purification of body and mind, then we can achieve our aim of yoga. Yoga, it's a science as well as art. Yoga is science as well as art. Yoga helps to improve our cardiovascular systems, improve the cardiac problems, proper digestive functioning, remove the stress, tension, helps to maintain a good posture, our body position like standing position, sitting positions. It's helped to maintain a good posture. Helps to remove from auto problems, disease, prevent premature aging, improve our health as well as develop hygienical habit in an individual. Next is elements of yoga. According to Ashtanga Yoga from Patanjali, what I have said, Patanjali is the founder of yoga. Patanjali is the founder of yoga, and Patanjali has given many types of yoga. And according to Ashtanga Yoga, there are eight elements. There are eight elements to attain purification of body and mind. By attending eight four states to attain purification of body and mind to achieve union of Atma with Paramatma. Okay, elements of yoga means first thing, the Ashtanga Yoga. According to Ashtanga Yoga, there are eight elements of yoga to achieve for union of Atma with Paramatma. And for union of Atma with Paramatma, the union of Atma with Paramatma is possible through purification of body and mind. And for purification of body and mind, we have this for purification of body and mind, we have to achieve this eight stages. First is yam. Yam means social discipline for the benefit of the society. Okay, yam means social discipline. There are universal commandments or morality guidelines for good behaviors in society. In other words, these are the basic principle for the benefit of society. Okay, yam, it is for the society. It is for the benefit of the society. Benefit for the society. In yam, there are five principle. There are five principle of yam. That is, अहिंसा, सत्य, असत्य, ब्रह्मचारी, अपरिग्रह, एक्सेट्रा. दिस आर द ए प्रिंसिपल ऑफ योगा विच वी हैव टू फॉलो. सत्य, सत्य मीन्स ट्रूथफुलनेस. वी शुड ऑलवेज स्पीक द ट्रूथ. वन शुड नेवर चीट अदर्स. ऑलवेज स्पीक ट्रूथ. असत्य, असत्य मीन्स नॉट स्टीलिंग. वन मस्ट नॉट स्टील एनी थिंग्स ऑफ अदर्स, इवन हिज थिंकिंग ऑल्सो. नॉट स्टील एनी थिंग्स, वेदर हिज एनी इक्विपमेंट, थिंकिंग एक्सेट्रा. इफ यू, बिकॉज इफ यू स्टील फ्रॉम अ पर्सन, इट मीन्स यू आर स्टीलिंग फ्रॉम द गॉड. देयरफॉर डोंट स्टील एनी थिंग ऑफ द अदर्स. ब्रह्मचार्य, ब्रह्मचार्य मीन्स वन मस्ट, ब्रह्मचार्य मीन्स वन मस्ट अवॉइड रीडिंग सेक्सुअल लिटरेचर्स. कीप आवर माइंड एट अ पीस, कंट्रोलिंग आवर माइंड. ओके, ब्रह्मचार्य मीन्स टू कीप वन सेंस ऑर्गन्स अंडर हिज कंट्रोल. ठीक है, कीपिंग आवर सेंस ऑर्गन्स अंडर आवर कंट्रोल. वन मस्ट अपरिग्रह, अपरिग्रह मीन्स वन शुड नॉट कलेक्ट वेल्ट और आइटम्स, अदर आइटम्स मोर देन ही रिक्वायर. ठीक है, जरूरत से ज़्यादा कुछ भी कलेक्ट मत करिए. ठीक है, डोंट कलेक्ट एनी थिंग्स मोर देन यू रिक्वायर्ड. दिस आर द फाइव प्रिंसिपल ऑफ यम. ओके, यम इट इज अ सोशल डिसिप्लिन फॉर द बेनिफिट ऑफ द सोसाइटी. For benefit of society, we have to follow these five principles: Satya, Asatya, Brahmacharya, Aparigraha. In which Ahimsa, Ahimsa means not violence, not always speak truth, never always speak truth. Okay, and Satya means truthfulness. Never cheat others. Always speak truth. Ahimsa, ahimsa means non-violence. Means not to hurt any other peoples, any other creatures. Okay, ahimsa, non-violence means not to hurt anybody, any creativity, physically or mentally. Okay, physically भी उसको hurt नहीं करना है, plus mentally भी. Don't hurt anybody. And also, you should not have any angry, jealous feeling, etc. Satya, satya means truthfulness. Asatya means not stealing anything of the others. Brahmacharya means controlling your sense organs under your control. Control your sense organs. Aparigraha means not to collect any things more than you require. Okay, not collect any things more than you require. Next is niyam. Niyam is individual discipline for the benefit, individual discipline for individual. These are personal observation or self purification by discipline. In other words, these are the principle for making individual healthy. Okay, niyam, it is for individual discipline for internal cleaning. In niyam also there are five principles, that is swach, santosh, tapa, swadhyaya, iswa paridhan. These are the five principles of niyam. In which swach means purity, cleanliness. One must be clean internally as well as externally. Okay, when internally plus externally, एकदम full clean, neat and clean. संतोष मीन्स मेंटेनिंग अ बैलेंस एटीट्यूड व्हाटएवर यू हैव फीलिंग ऑफ सेटिस्फैक्शन. संतोष में फीलिंग ऑफ सेटिस्फैक्शन, रिमेनिंग हैप्पी विथ व्हाटएवर यू हैव. तप मीन्स एक्सेप्टिंग द लॉस ऑल्सो इन अ पॉजिटिव माइंड, वेदर यू आर लॉस और विन, बी इन पॉजिटिव. ट्रेन अ पर्सन टू फेस द डिफिकल्टी सो दैट ही कैन मूव टूवर्ड्स द अल्टीमेट गोल. ओके, तप मीन्स गिविंग ट्रेनिंग टू द पर्सन टू फेस द डिफिकल्टी सो दैट ही कैन लीव हिज लाइफ हैप्पीली. इट हेल्प्स टू अचीव द सक्सेस एंड फेलियर्स इन अ पॉजिटिव माइंड. सेल्फ डिसिप्लिन, दैट इज सेल्फ डिसिप्लिन. एंड स्वध्य, स्वध्य मीन्स सेल्फ स्टडी, नोइंग योर सेल्फ, अंडरस्टैंडिंग योर सेल्फ. फॉर अंडरस्टैंडिंग ईश्वर परिधान, ईश्वर परिधान मीन्स devoting everything to the God. Whatever you have, devote it to the God and thank the God for whatever you have. These are the five principle of niyam. Okay, niyam, it is for individual discipline. Asan, it is the slow stretching exercise activity which we perform to improve our whole body fitness. Okay, asan, it is a slow stretching exercise which we perform to improve our whole body. Next is pranayam. Pranayam is a systematic breathing exercise. It is a systematic and rhythmic breathing exercise in which we inhale, exhale and hold our breath. Inhale means purak, exhale rechak and kumbhak means holding our breath. In this types of pranayam, there are various type of pranayam like anulom vilom, kapalbhati, bhamri, sitkari, etc. We do pranayam for internal to improve the internal functioning Pratyahar, these are performed to improve intellectual capability by withdrawal of sense. Okay, pratyahar means withdrawal of sense. Your sense organ is no more responding. You are withdrawing your sense organ. Therefore, your sense organ is no more respond to the outward object. Dharna means concentration, full concentration, fixing the attention on a single object. That is high concentration. One should perform under the ever guidance. Okay, dharna means concentration, concentrating on a single point, fixed point. Dhyan means controlling our body, that is meditation. Through meditations, we are able to control our mind. Full controlling over the mind. Whatever the mind say, you will do because you have control your mind. Samadhi is a super consciousness. It is a last stage where dhyana reaches its climax, that reaches its end point. When we achieve in this last state samadhi, it is a state of union of soul with the God, union of atma with paramatma, merging consciousness and salvations. These are the eight elements. After achieving these eight elements, then only there will be the union of Atma with Paramatma. In elements of yoga, This elements of yoga, Ashtang yoga. According to Ashtang yoga, there are eight elements of yoga. After achieving these eight elements, it's helping purifications of body and mind. Then only we can achieve our aim. Yam means social discipline for the benefit of society. For the benefit of society, we should always follow these five principles. That's this ahimsa, satya, asatya, brahmacharya, aparigraha. These are the five principles which we should follow for the benefit of society. Niyam means individual discipline for the benefit of individual. For the benefit individual discipline, there are five principles for individual discipline. That is Niyam, Swachh, Santosh, Tapa, Aparigraha and Iswa Paridhan. These are the five principles of Niyam which we have to follow for self-purification for individual. Asan is a slow stretching exercise. In this, we hold our final position for some time. That is for approximately 30 seconds to 20 seconds, we hold the final position. And pranayam is a systematic and rhythmic breathing exercise. Okay, it's just systematic and rhythmic breathing exercise in which we inhale, exhale and hold our breath. Pratyahar is withdraw of sense. Your sense organs is no more a response to the external object, external world. You will not feel any pain. Dharna means concentration, full concentration, fixing the attention on a single object, full concentration over a single object. And Dhyan means meditation, full controlling over the mind. In Dhyan, you are able to control your mind, and you are able to control your mind through meditation. So through meditations, you are able to control your mind. Samadhi, it is the last stage in which there will be the union of Atma with Paramatma. It is a super consciousness stage. These are the five elements of yoga. Today we have discussed the meaning of yoga, importance and elements of yoga. Once again, we'll do revision. Yoga means, first thing, the word yoga, it is derived from the Sanskrit word use, and the use means to join. So yoga means union of Atma with Paramatma, means joining of Atma with Paramatma. And the purpose of yoga is the purpose of yoga is to provide sound body, sound mind. And the aim of yoga is self-identification, self-perfections. And to achieve our aim, we have to purify our body and mind. We have to purify our body, mind. And for purifications of body and mind, we have to achieve the eight elements of yoga. After achieving this eight, after covering these eight states of yoga, then there will be the purification of our body and mind. Okay, for purification of body and mind, we have to achieve this eight states of yoga. Yam, Niyam, Asan, Pranayam, Pratyahar, Dharna, Dhyan, Samadhi. After this, There is a union of Atma with Paramatma.